Hi everybody, I'm Stephanie from Razzledazzlerabbitry and Yarns LLC, and in today's video we're going to show you how you can take freshly washed Gotland locks like this and how you can actually pick these apart, getting them ready to go through a hand carder. So if you want to spin them up and blend them with Angora or just spin them up as it is, we'll show you how to do that without a triple picker or any picker whatsoever. So make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell because we release videos every single Saturday and Monday. Now we're gonna set the camera at an angle here, kind of an odd angle, but that's okay. So these are the locks. These have been picked apart before. You can see how a picked apart lock is really kind of fluffy and airy. You can't see a lot of the locks themselves when it's been picked apart. So the reason why you want to do this, the reason why you want to pick apart your locks before you hand card, is because when a lock, after a lock has been washed, so this is a lock and it is a lot of wool together still. And when you have a lot of wool together like this, this does not go through a drum carder or a hand carder, like a fine tooth hand carder, easily. So you want to pick this apart so that this can be blended better with fibers. And triple pickers and pickers can be expensive tools to buy. So before perhaps you have a tool like that or you invest in a tool like that, this is an option of what you can do. You also want to do this to get little things like this out. And this is just a little second cut. And a second cut is a short piece of wool. So we continue on and we just take little bits like this and we spread them apart with our fingers like this. We open them up and what you're left with is fluffy, airy locks, fluffy, airy wool, raw wool like this. And so we just sort it out and we put it in this. Now these are the drying racks that I have. So this is very thin wire and wood. There's actually two drying racks here. And I just take the separated wool that's been pulled apart and teased apart, and I move it from this drying rack, which has not been processed yet, to this drying rack. So if we were to continue on, we'll put the camera back down. And we just take another lock. This is a thinner lock. Let's adjust this. And you just do the same thing. You use your fingers and you tease it apart. So this may be, this is an option. This is literally the most simple option if you don't have a tool that can take your locks and spread them apart like this. So you literally can just use your hands. And this is something you can do, for example, when you're riding in the car or if you are just sitting in front of the TV or doing whatever, you just take it and you keep pulling it apart like this. And so the more you spread the fibers apart, the more you spread the locks apart, the easier that this is going to blend together. Now, if you are trying to make a yarn and you don't want it well blended together, then this is not something that you would do. Because the more you tease this apart, the more you pick this apart by hand, the more that this fiber has all that air in between it, and when you blend it with another fiber, then they can actually blend together very well. There's space for them to blend together well, as compared to if you were to take a fiber like this. And what I mean by blending is if you put two fibers together and you want them to evenly and consistently come together. So this, even though this has been washed, there's just the teensiest, tiniest little bit of vegetable matter that can easily be pulled out. Nothing difficult to work with. And you just continue on. Just kind of pulling it apart. So for those of you who've been watching this channel, you know I've never done a video on using a picker because I don't have a picker. And for a while, a couple of years ago, I really had considered investing in a picker. And they are, not only are they're very useful pieces of equipment if you're going to be using a lot of fiber that requires being picked apart like this. But they are, they're also dangerous pieces of equipment because a picker is a tool that has many, many teeth, many large teeth. So if you think of nails, a whole bunch of nails sticking up, a picker does what my hands, my fingers are doing right here, where I'm taking these individual locks and pulling them apart. But it does it by using pieces of metal like nails, and it kind of goes like this, and it shreds them apart. So when you have a tool like that, if you have small kids or animals or people coming into your home, whatever it is, that's definitely a tool you want to be very careful with. An amount of wool like this that I have to tease apart, to pick apart, this will take quite a while. However, it can be a good activity. It can be a good activity to do if you have, for example, a young child who wants to learn how to work with wool with you and do yarny things with you, and perhaps they're just not ready for knitting, or perhaps they're just not ready for crocheting yet. This is a skill that is useful when making yarn that young children can do. And for people who are just getting started with wool and just getting started with yarn and making your own yarn or processing sheep's fleeces, this is something that gives you great hands-on experience that shows you a lot about the wool, teaches you just a lot. Just touching the wool and looking at the staple length, which of course the staple length means the length of the fiber. So for staple length, this is the actual length of the fiber, that's staple length. And it teaches you to look for crimp, teaches you to look for second cuts like this right here. That's a second cut. We take that out. But perhaps more important than everything we've talked about is this is and remains the most environmentally friendly and sustainable way to process and pick apart locks is just by hand. It doesn't require electricity, doesn't require any sort of fossil fuel consumption to do this. Just your own abilities. And the more you work with wool, the more you get familiar with all sorts of different parts. For example, this crimp, this is actually, even in an individual sheep, and sheep fleece, there's just different amounts of crimp. So let's find a really different piece here. Some pieces have a lot, like this. This is a very tightly coiled piece as compared to a piece like this that's very loose. And that's the same sheep's fleece. This Scotland wool is it's from my favorite person to purchase sheep's fleeces from, for Scotland wool. And I can put the link down below Just absolutely beautiful fleeces. Very minimal vegetable matter. Vegetable matter is like plant or animal material in the wool. Just very little amounts of it. And that's what you're looking for. Here's a second cut. Few second cuts. Low vegetable matter. Good, clean, nice wool. So this is our pile that we've done thus far. This is all the wool that we've picked apart so far. And this is wonderful, fluffy wool. When we take this, we can blend it together with Angora very, very easily. And we can put this through the hand carder. We can hand card with this very easily. So that's just how you pick apart your, that's just how you pick apart your locks of sheep's wool after it's been washed without using any sort of additional tool besides your own hands. Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in our next video.